Good evening, Americans. This is your favorite alien speaking on Thursday, April 18th. Me and Bubba here are looking at the afternoon. We finally got over the Mueller report, 400 pages. Want to do a report and call it the Mueller report is out. And here is your favorite alien's interpretation of the Mueller report. And what's going to happen? Number one. The Attorney General, Mr. Barr, should never have made the comments he did and tried to defend President Trump. He made things worse, and he made himself look like a dum-dum. That's bad for an AG, you know. Anyway, be that as it may, the second thing is, the report says there is, as Mr. President would say, no collusion with the Russians. Well, yeah, that's what it says. But then, with respect to the investigation, the investigators and prosecutors stopped short of saying yes and no about obstruction of justice. And Mr. Trump has been playing hanky-panky. As you notice, he's been purging all offices that were anti-him, especially on the Russian investigation, you know, like Comey, Mr. McCabe. He wanted to fire Mr. Rosenstein. He fired the first attorney general there, Mr. Sessions, because he recused himself. Well, Mr. Sessions, he wanted him to 100% back him down. That's not the role of the AG, Mr. Barr, and it's not the role of the AG to defend the president. You are responsible for the Justice Department, the arm of the law of the U.S. government. You're not responsible or allegiance to the President of the United States, even though he did appoint you. Your office is independent, and it should be. That's what the founders of the Constitution made it to be. Also, for those Democrats who say, oh, we got him, obstruction of justice, they're passing the buck to us. Yo-ho. Red light here, Democrats, because all they are saying is, we want to pass the buck. We didn't see anything good. We didn't see anything bad. There was some hanky-panky here, and that's all they're trying to say. Now, we know that President Trump has hanky-panky, and he admits it. Okay. Does it come to high crimes and misdemeanors? Well, maybe or maybe not. But here's the problem you got, Democrats, and you Republicans develop a backbone here, because you're going to need one. So for the Democrats, first off, Mrs. Pelosi's right. Impeachment will lead you down a road you don't want to go. And I give you an example, actually two examples of that, and Mrs. Pelosi already knows about them. Number one, the most recent impeachment proceedings with President Clinton and the Republicans, they controlled the House at a time, with Newt Gingrich and Congressman Barr, remember? Robert Barr, he from Georgia, he was a gung-ho, let's go get Clinton. Remember that? And he tried everything. He even was part of the prosecuting team that was up there trying to get him. But the Democrats controlled the Senate. And no matter how much he tried, Clinton did not do any crimes that rose to the height of high crimes and misdemeanors. All he did was hanky-panky with Lewinsky. And then he went on national television and said, quote, I had no sex with that lady, Miss Lewinsky. So you see, did he lie to Congress? Oh, yeah. Did the people that Mr. President Trump lie to Congress? Oh, yeah. But is that considered high crimes and misdemeanors? According to the Constitution, no. And the next impeachment, 1868. Remember the impeachment of President Johnson? By the radical Republicans. And President Johnson was a Democrat, by the way, guys. Now, President Johnson he was in a no-win scenario here. They had killed President Lincoln. He didn't know what was going on, left or right. He was just a poor guy at the wrong place at the wrong time. The radical Republicans wanted to punish the South, so they tried to impeach him. It took that one senator, Ross, I believe, to vote no, because he had other things that he considered. Number one, constitutional crisis. Number two, save the Union. And he did for the next 100 years or so, until 120 years, until the Republicans tried to impeach Clinton, and now you Democrats are trying to return to favor with Trump. But here's the problem. Is President Trump guilty of hanky-panky? Yes. Is he guilty of high crimes and misdemeanors? Not really, according to the founders of the Constitution, and that's who you should be looking at, Democrats. The founders of the Constitution. What they meant. Is he a bad guy? Well, technically, I'll take the fifth. But I will say he's a bully. But high crimes and misdemeanors, I don't see it. Neither does Senator or House Speaker Pelosi. So you AOCs in Congress, and you Omars in Congress, who want to, let's go get them, hold your horses, huh? Because you know that both of your parties, no matter what happens, they're going to take a beating in 2020. AOC, you're looking at your life to be reelected to Congress, and so is Congressman Omar. Congressman Tlaib, to you I say, thank you for following the right path, and to you, if I were the Michiganders, I would re-vote you back into office. But the other two, no. And as far as the Mueller report, it's as bad as the Starr report. But then again, special counsels, Archibald Cox, remember him? Saturday Night Massacre. But this is what I'm saying, Americans. Choose what you may, but the Democrats and Republicans, they got to develop backbone. Thanks.